Okay, so hello and welcome back to an Arduino tutorial. Let's start off with looking into what we'll be making today. Today we'll be making an Arduino controlled TFT screen. This is just a simple example using a button to toggle an LED light, because we want to keep our main focus on the TFT screen related code today. So for the sake of simplicity, we will be showing the current state of the LED light on the screen. Now let's get started.
Next to releasing videos about Arduino programming, we also released our electronics projects webshop. We will start selling packages with all the parts you need in this and future videos. By buying from our webshop, you get the parts you need and support the channel.
So today's required parts are an Arduino Uno, an LCD display, a breadboard, a button, and an LED light. And for the LED light, we need a 220 ohm resistor, and for the button, we need a 10k ohm resistor. And how do we connect things? With cables, of course. So cables are required as always.
Now let's get started assembling everything. We'll be running a wire from 5 volts to the plus of the breadboard and from ground to the minus of the breadboard, and then connect the other side of the breadboard as well. Then next up will be the LED light. So let's run a wire from digital pin number 6 on the Arduino Uno to the breadboard. Then connect it to the resistor and connect it to the anodes of the LED light. Connect the cathode of the LED light to the ground. And let's get started doing the button. So for the button, we will be running a wire from digital pin number 7 to one side of the push button. I'll be using the left side and then the top left side. Then connect the bottom left side to ground using the 10k ohm resistor, and let's connect the bottom right to the power. So now let's look into the pinout of the LCD screen. As you can see, next to all the pins there are some text, and the text corresponds with this list, and we explain how to hook it up. So the first pin with LED will be hooked up to 3.3 volts. Then SCK will be to digital pin 13, SDA to pin 11, AD to pin 8, reset pin 9, CS to pin 10, ground to ground of course, and VCC is to 5 volts. Now once you've assembled the LCD screen, the end result should look like this. So the LCD screen with everything hooked up correctly, the LED and the push button. Everything should be hooked up correctly now. So for the next part, we'll be writing some codes. But before we do that, let's look at the flowchart. So when the Arduino turns on, which will be at start, the LCD will display that the LED is turned off, and the LED will be turned off. Then once we receive a button press, so button pressed, then we go to yes, the LCD will display that the LED will be turned on, and the LED will turn on. And then once we press the button again, the LED will be turned off, and the LCD will display that the LED is turned off. Then when no button is pressed, the state will stay the same and we will not update the screen. So now we've looked at the flowchart, so it's time to write some code. Of course, we have to create a project before we can write some code, so let's open up the Platform.io dashboard, and once it's been loaded, click this new project button. We'll give it a name of Arduino Screen Tutorial, and we select the board, which is the Arduino Uno. We can keep the default location and hit the Finish button. So now, once the project has been created, we want to open up the main.cpp. What we want to do is we want to include two libraries, which is one of which is the Adafruit underscore GFX library, and the other one is for our screen itself, which is the Adafruit ST7735.h. Now, as you can see, there are two errors for both the libraries. So what we want to do is we want to install this library, which will install this library, which will then install its dependencies. So to make all of this happen, to make the library manager recursively download all of the libraries necessary to make this code work, we have to change one setting in the platform.io.ini file. So let's open up the platform.io.ini, and what we want to change is an library LDF mode. So what we want to do is set this library LDF mode to chain plus. This will recursively download all of the libraries necessary to make the scope work. Now, there's one more thing we want to do, and that's actually install the correct library. So let's open up this platform.io and then click this button to open up the libraries. And let's search for a library called Adafruit ST7735. As you can see, there's the library. Let's click on it and add to project. Select the correct project, which is Arduino Screen Tutorial, and click this Add button. This will now recursively download all the libraries we need to interact with the screen. Okay, and as you can see, the libraries have been successfully installed, but there will be one issue. So let's open up the main.cpp, and let's click this Build. As you can see, we have one error, which is the Adafruit Gray OLED CPP. So let's open up this .pio folder and then open up the libdeps, so library dependencies, and let's open up the Adafruit GFX library. Now let's find these two files, which is the gray OLED CPP and gray OLED.h, and let's just delete them. So delete and move to recycle bin. And now that's done. Let's open up platform.io again and click build again. And there are no errors anymore, which is a good sign. So now we can start writing the code. So once you've opened up your main.cpp file again, we want to include one more library, which is already installed, which is the SPI library. And now we're all set to go. The next thing we want to do is define all the pins we will be using. So let's define a pin for the TFT underscore CS, which will be pin number 10. Then define a pin for TFT RST, which will be pin 9. Define a pin for the TFT DC, which will be 8. Now that's all the pins we need for the screen, but we have two more things, which is the LED and the button. So we define a pin for LED. LED pin is on 6, and the button pin is on 7. Now we've got all of the pins done. We want to do one more thing, and that's we want to create a boolean for the LED. So is the LED turned on? And we'll default this to false. Next up is creating an object that we can use to interact with the screen. So let's create a Adafruit 7735 TFT screen. So let's call it TFT, Adafruit ST7735, and we'll have to give it some parameters. The first that we have to input is the TFT CS, then next up is the DC, and finally the RS. So now all of that is done, what we want to do is we want to write everything we need to do in the setup. So first of all, as always, we do the pin modes. So LED pin, which is output, and pin mode of the button is an input. Then the next thing is we want to initialize the TFT screen. We can do that by using this method on the TFT object called init r, and we have to specify the option for it, which will be the init r underscore black tab. Then next up is we want to fill the screen, so let's fill screen with ST7735 black, so it's a black background. And then we want to update the screen. We'll write this function in a bit. Now for a loop, so the code related to the flowchart, what we want to do is If the LED is turned on, we want to digital write to the LED pin a high signal. And you can guess this next part, but for if the LED is not turned on, we want to digital write to the LED pin a low signal. Next up is reading the value of the button. So let's create a variable for button value and let's set it to digital read and then the button pin. Button pin. So now if the button is pressed, so if the button value is high, what we want to do is we want to toggle the state of the LED and we want to update the screen. So is LED on equals exclamation mark is LED on and we want to update the screen. So now let's write the update screen method. So we'll create a new void update screen. And now we want to dive into all the TFT screen related stuff. So first of all, and this is related to how you position your TFT screen, we want to set the rotation. So let's tft.setRotation. And for me to easily see the text, I have to set the rotation to 3. And then tft.setTextWrap false. So because we don't want to wrap the text like you might know from Notepad or some other text editor, where if the text runs out of your screen, it wraps to the next line. We don't want that to happen because we want to keep control of every single line. So the next thing will be that we want to fill the screen again. And this time it's black again. Then we want to set the cursor. Set cursor to 0, 0. So the top left. Then we want to tft.setTextSize to 2. And we want to print an empty line. So print line with an empty text. So now everything after this is pretty much related to what you want to do with a TFT screen. So if you want to write hello world, you can just change this text to hello world. Or if you want to do something else, just change the text and you will display it on the screen. So for us, we want to start with a new line. And then the next thing we want to do is I'll just copy and paste this a few times. And the second thing we want to say is Dapper Dino. Then we want an empty line again. And we say TFT screens. Then we want another empty line. Then after this empty line, we want to say if the LED is turned on or off. So the LED is, and now we want to check if the LED is on. So if the LED is on, we TFT print line on. Otherwise, we TFT print line off. So that's pretty much all of the code we have to write. So let's upload the code to our Arduino using this upload button. And once it's been successfully uploaded, let's look at the end result.
Thanks for watching, and I hope you found this tutorial useful. If so, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.